I bring you greetings to Jaguar Nation, a Maceo Walker Middle School, home of the mighty Jaguars, where we are focused on rigor, relationships, and results. This is our quarter three honor celebration, and we are so, so, so happy to celebrate all of our students who have been deemed citizenship honors, or students who have honor roll, distinguished honor roll, and the principals list. So without any further ado, we're ready to get started. We're going to introduce our MC this morning, Dean Daniel Robertson, our great Dean of Students, and he's going to take us further into this great celebration or program. Have a great day.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Dean Robertson, and I'm honored to serve as your MC for the third quarter honors program. We will begin our program with the welcome by Anaya Partee, followed by the vision, mission, and purpose statements by Shamar Brownlee.
Good morning to the activating teachers, parents, relatives, and classmates. I'm Anaya Partee, and it is my honor to welcome you to IOWS Honor Program. Today, we recognize those students who have worked hard to achieve academic excellence for the third 9 weeks. They have followed the rules and surpassed our teachers' expectations. Parents and relatives, we also honor you, for without your support, we could not achieve our goals. Thank you, and again, we welcome you.
Good morning. My name is Shamara Valley with your mission, vision, and purpose statements. Mission statement. The mission of Maceo Walker Middle School is to ensure all students master state-mandated standards, read with comprehension, write with clarity, and compute with accuracy while developing reasoning and problem-solving skills for college and career readiness. Vision statement. Maceo Walker Middle School stakeholders visualize our school as a learning organization that prepares all students for success in school and in life. Purpose statement. Our purpose is to support the social and behavioral climate of our school by reducing student misconduct, referrals, reducing suspensions and expulsions, and training staff to provide emotional and social support to students experiencing adverse childhood experiences. Thank you.
Thank you, Anaya and Shamara. And now we'll have a special presentation by the talented Aaliyah Bolton.
Decided long ago believe the children are our future. Teach them well, let them lead the way. Show them all the beauty they possess inside. Give them a sense of pride to make it easier. Let the children's laughter remind us how we used to be. I decided long ago never to walk in anyone's shadow. If I fail, if I succeed, at least I live it. I believe no matter what they take from me, they can't take away my dignity. Because the greatest love is happening to me.
Wow, that was absolutely remarkable. Beautifully done, Aaliyah. It's just amazing how much talent resides here at 1900 East Range Road. Now we'll have a special presentation from our keynote speaker, our very own family engagement specialist, Dr. Kevin Patterson.
Greetings, 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 and good morning. I am Dr. Kevin Patterson, Jr., the Family Engagement Specialist here at A. Maceo Walker Middle School. And to Dr. Brittenham and to our assistant principals and to the faculty staff and the parents that's watching of the A. Maceo Walker Middle School and to all of our honorees today. It says be ye also ready, so I'm going to do what I have to do. So we can move on in this program. But I do find it a great honor to be able to speak to you all this morning. A lot of you I have had the opportunity of interacting with, whether sports or just throughout the hallways. So I'm honored to speak today. But as I pondered in this short period of time, what to talk about this morning, and what came to mind was to let you all know that you were born with a purpose. Yes, we all come from different backgrounds and different financial statuses and different families, but the truth of the matter is that we all were born with a purpose, and that purpose is to strive to be the best person we can be. And I must tell you that as a 36-year-old man, that life hasn't been easy and life won't be easy. But I believe that the teachers and the parents that's watching this morning will concur that we all face situations that may try to deter us from our purpose. But a lot of times we miss our purpose because we wait so long to establish and set goals for our lives. But if I can pause for a moment and tell you that we have something unique inside of us that makes us a unique person and line us up with our purpose. You are not unique when you disobey your parents or disobey your teachers or want to be a part of games, want to participate in the life of the streets, or want to wear your pants below your waist. But you are unique when you go to school, set goals for your life, wear your clothes properly, obey your parents and obey your teachers. But most of all, when you find the things in you that will make you a better and unique person. And it is proven that when you don't do or do not have to wait until you're out on your own before you discover your own purpose. What do you mean, Dr. Patterson? Well, I'm glad that you asked. There was a young man here in Memphis that attended Rozier Elementary named Mosiah Bridges. And at the age of nine, Mosiah founded and started his own company called Mo's Bowls. He didn't find fun in what regular nine-year-olds would do at that time. So he took his grandmom's scrap fabric and began to sew and make his own bow ties. And now he is known all over the world for his bow ties. So honorees and to everybody that's watching, I want to tell you that your future is closer than you really think. I was driving just yesterday and I looked over in my mirror and I saw something that struck me, and you all see it all the time. In the mirror, it has some little words that said, "Objects in the mirror appear closer than they really are." So in other words, as I finish this morning, your future is closer than you think. So go ahead and plan for the future. Go ahead and write your business plans. Go ahead and apply for colleges. Go ahead and invest into yourself. Because if I was in church, I would tell you to grab your neighbor's hand and say, "Neighbor, if you only knew what I see in my future looks mighty promising, because you were born to win. You wasn't born to lose. You wasn't born to fail. You wasn't born to major and sag in your pants. You wasn't born to major in running with the right game. You wasn't born to walk the streets and do drugs, but you were born with a purpose and you were born to win." So yes, I believe in the lyrics of the song by Kevin Davidson, "Born to Win." He says that destiny is calling me to fulfill what God said I'll be. Eyes haven't seen nor ears haven't heard what shall be. You were born to win. Some said you would lose, but they lied. Others said you would fail, and they lied again. But don't you fear, the best is yet to come. Because you were born to win. You were created with a purpose, created with a plan. And all you can say, "Lord, I was made by your hand. I won't fail. I will succeed. Because I am a survivor." Y'all, I am a survivor. And with him, I can do all things. So remember that you were born to win. Thank you. That's all I have this morning.
Wow, what a powerful message. Thank you so much, Dr. Patterson. Remember, we were born to win, Jaguars. Such a powerful message. Now we'll have the presentation of our honor students by Ms. Spears and the administrative staff. It has been my pleasure serving as your MC this morning. But before I pass the microphone, I'd be remiss if I didn't take this opportunity to recite the Jaguar affirmation. I am a Jaguar. I use my powerful jaws to speak intelligence and encouragement. My strength is made evident by my ability to do right, even when alone. I optimize my life by thinking and acting positively. I think, live, and breathe greatness, because that is what Jaguars do. Jaguars, again, it has been my pleasure serving as your MC. Now I pass it on to Ms. Spears.
Good morning, Jaguars. I have the honor of recognizing those students that have achieved all E's in conduct. We're going to start with sixth grade citizenship honors. Akia Andrews, Jayla Banyan, Landon Blake, Mantarius Brown, Leslie Castaneda, Sadaria Cryer, Micaiah Davison, Tatiana Eccles Bryant, Amaya Irvin, Dariana Foster, Kalidou Gadayo, Brooklyn Gibson, Nevia Gray, Madison Cruz, Lonnie Hall, Ja'Kayla Hampton, Jameel Hardaway, Mariah Harper Pruitt, Janiah Hawthorne, Amari Hickman, Wade Hunt, Tierra Jackson, Ayana Jones, Isaiah Lopez, Jaden McGee, Jamarian Magruder, Litha Mandaya, Eldra Moore, Courtney Mosby, Tamaya Parker, Antonasia Perry, Jonathan Pollock, Autumn Radcliffe, Edward Riley, Madison Shives, Renee Thompson, Trevion Thomas, and Angelia Woods. Congratulations, sixth grade. Our seventh grade citizenship, Mirica Abrams, Molly Ba, Muhammad Ba, Omar Berry, Demba Berry, Alicia Bell, Atrell Broomfield, Eliza Brunson, Ariana Burnett, Devarion Buxton, Antoine Kathy Golden, Landon Clark, Toria Coleman, Malik Cross, Brendan Davis, Kaylin Davis, Suri DeJesus, Isaac Ellis, Antonio Farmer, Demariana Foster, Colburn Fultrell, Triviana Henderson, Omarion Hoskins, Donnell Houston, Camilla Hull, Jalicia Ingram, Kiana Jackson, Carmenique Jennings, Carlos Johnson, Rashad Johnson, Xavier Jones, Patrick Magram, Clifford Magram, Elizabeth Martinez, Sean Newsom, Trenice Olden, Anaya Partee, Marcellus Perry, Vincent Porter, Jacoby Ransfer, Denaya Rogers, Nyla Sanders, Takarion Settles, Jermaine Shelvin, Lateria Smith, Kayla Smith, Ladarius Smith, Keyshawn Underwood, Jamiah Watson, Carissa Williams, and Jania Wilson. Our sixth grade citizenship, Euro Annie, Carnesia Braxton, Jacarion Caradine, Material Coleman, Marcus Duche, Jakiva Funches, Tariq Grayer, Harona Sai, Rashad Magram, Umu Ndongo, Shalane Neal, Tanaya Settles, Kia Williams, and D'Angelo Worthy. Congratulations, you all.
Honor roll, grade point average of 3.0 to 3.5. Sixth grade, Carmelo Fleming, Jalen Gillespie, Letha Meander, Charlize Sims. Congratulations, sixth grade. Seventh grade, Khadisha Ba, Landon Clark, Jalenzia Ingram, Rashad Jones, Tristan Robinson, and Lateria Smith. Eighth grade, Asante Berry, Tanaya Barmalathu, Anthony Bowen, Mia Douglas, Jasmine Goss, Kennedy Howard, Reginald Johnson, Traydon Johnson, Kevion Patterson, Tashana Redmond, Destiny Sanders, and Gabriel Gambi. Congratulations, all the honor students.
Distinguished honor roll, grade point average 3.6 to 3.9. Distinguished honor roll, sixth grade. Desiree DeYoung, Diamond Johnson, Uli Kane, Aziz Lopez, Jamarion Magruder. Congratulations, sixth grade. Distinguished honor roll, seventh grade. Sahari Jesus, Nyla Sanders, Kayla Smith, Jamarion Watson. Congratulations, seventh grade. Distinguished honor roll, eighth grade. Amaya Abram, Jamiah Bates, Alpha Diallo, Capricia Jackson, Real McCoy, Jamarcus Olden, Leah Pugh, and D'Angelo Worthy. Congratulations, eighth grade. I'm sorry, Morgan Yarbrough.
Good morning, parents and students. I'm Assistant Principal Banks, and I have the honor this morning of presenting the Principal's List honors to students that have a grade point average of 4.0 and above, which means that they received all A's on their report card. So proud of these students. For sixth grade, we have Ayana Chandler. For seventh grade, we have Artrell Broomfield, Gogo Diop, Elizabeth Martinez, and Carissa Williams. Our eighth grade principal's list honorees are Ramada Berry, Jamarcus Bates, Corday Bell, Zayala Booker, Shamara Brownlee, Benta DeYoung, Diali Diop, Dakara Flowers, Shaylin Neal, Janaba Yang, and Haruna Sai. We are so proud of your accomplishments. Congratulations to you all, Principal's List honorees.
And now we turn to Dr. Brittenham for our closing remarks.
Definitely, this has been an honors program that we will remember for many, many years to come. I certainly want to thank all of our parents, all of our teachers and staff, all of our students for doing such a tremendous job during this unprecedented pandemic. You all have been absolutely amazing. And the fact that we have so many students who had citizenship honor roll, and we all know middle school students love to talk. So the fact that our students were able to be silent and listen to great first teaching from our great teachers, it is absolutely amazing. And then all of our songs and all of our presentations from our students today, all of our keynote speakers, they did a tremendous job on today. Dr. Patterson was absolutely awesome. And so we certainly thank him for those great words of wisdom and those nuggets that he has imparted into the lives of our students. And so certainly without any further ado, I want to give special thanks. I want to give special thanks to our teachers, who certainly were truly appreciated for all that you have done to make a difference in the lives of our students. And then definitely we want to give a special thanks to all of our parents. Thank you, parents. Thank you, thank you, thank you for impressing upon your children the importance of receiving an education. We also want to give a special thanks to all of our students at Amasia Walker Middle School and the Twins program. And then we absolutely have to thank our Dean of Students who orchestrated all of this, got all of this together. He served as our MC today and our producer. And when you heard our special baby Malaya sing, Miss Bolton sing today, the greatest love of all, she was actually being accompanied by our very own talented teacher, Mr. Valeris. And so he was the musician and the videographer. And so we are so, so excited for this. And so this was a great, great session today. And so thank you to all of our teachers, parents, and community members and staff. And also I have to give special recognition to my three outstanding assistant principals. They are the greatest in the nation, Ms. L. Banks, Ms. Hervey, Mr. Robert Washington, and then our outstanding, we have the best counselors on this side of heaven, our very own Ms. Tasha Spears, our very own Mr. Rodney Smith, and our very own Ms. Nevels, Ms. LaShondra Nevels. And so job well done to all three of them for just being outstanding. They made our Teachers Appreciation Week second to none. And so we certainly give them recognition for their hard work and their excellence. And as we close and as we end this wonderful, wonderful school year, we are looking for all of you to be back in the house when school opens for the 21-22 school year. Remember, students, we're expecting for you to remember our classroom or our school-wide behavior expectations to be respectful, be responsible, and be right. And remember, as always, even as we end this year, LA, you already know, love a Maceo. And congratulations again to each one of you. We are Jaguar Nation strong, and the best is yet to come as we move forward into the 21-22 academic school year. Again, we celebrate each one of you. We thank you for your hard work and your heart work. And in the words of our superintendent, together we must believe. Together we will achieve. Together we are reimagining 901. God bless you all and enjoy your summer vacation. We are Jaguar Strong, and at Maceo Walker Middle School is a great place for teachers to teach, students to learn, and all to grow.